Hello and welcome back to our next part in The Vanishing of Ethan Carter. And last time we left, we'd literally just got this train rolling and we'd moved it down. It didn't actually save, so I'm just going to move the train back down again to where we were before. Don't need to mention the beautiful graphics because they just are ridiculous. So I'm going to move the train back down to the bottom end of here. Let's see if we can work out what the hell's going on. Okay, so let's turn the train off and get out. You know, I've been thinking about it. This body down here, or should I say up there, I'm starting to wonder now whether this guy who died... I'm not sure about this petrol. Maybe it was just spilt. Yeah, we know about the rail car. Yeah, we know. I'm wondering, you know, whether this body here... whether this guy untied somebody else up here to save them. The person then ran down this track and jumped in front of the train. He pushed him out of the way, but unfortunately got his legs chopped off. That's what I'm guessing, because the whole point of this game is that we're actually a detective and we're trying to work out this case. So that's what I'm thinking. These, even though it looks like he's been dragged, he could have been dragged. And the fact that we found blood on the crankshaft could have been a mercy killing. It could have been because this guy's in agony. They decided to put him out of his misery. Now, they're showing me a rock with a handprint on it. Now, where is this rock? I'm guessing there's going to be a rock around here somewhere. But what would be the point in being able to move the train, or is that just something just to make us think that there's something to do with the train? There's nothing else on the train. Well, we've got plenty of rocks around here, but these rocks don't look big enough to me to be able to... I mean, if the crank's down there... Oh, what's this here? That rock's... It's that rock there, isn't it? So did the cabbies head in with a rock and not the actual crowbar? The plot thickens, Detective Lon. There's got to be a rock somewhere. Poor bastard, he had his legs chopped off. His legs chopped off and then his head caved in by even a crowbar or a bloody rock. I wonder if there's anything up here. It did show this way. No, I can't get up here. Interesting. Was the rock underneath the train? Is that why we moved it? My spidey senses are telling me. They're telling me that the graphics are freaking amazing, but we know that. Yes, we know it's... told us that it was... What's this? No. Alright, well, it told us that it was definitely this way. Telling us to inspect. We know about this, don't we? Yeah. There's no rocks around here. It's definitely this direction. Aha, what's this? We found it. Yep, it's got blood on it. So that's what they caved his head in with. Right. So look at the body again. Should we get any more clues? Oh. What is that? Is that his arms missing? Was it missing? No, it's tucked under him. I don't know what that means. Puzzling indeed. And that's where the rock went. Oh, fix. Now, why? Why would we have to put the rock back? Still not sure how the train plays into all this. Obviously, we know that there's blood on the front. Let's check our little friend up here again. What are you showing me? What are you showing me now? The body is not giving me any other clues, or at least I don't think it is. I know his legs are chopped off. The rail car was over there. Ah, do we have to put the rail car back? It's almost like we're undoing the actual crime. So let's put the train back to where it was. It's almost like we're retracing the actual steps. So let's move it forward. Let's see if we've got that in the right position. See if that makes any difference. Right, so I need to move it forward to about in front of this tree here. Okay, let's try that. Or should we move it to where the actual body was hit? I wonder. Really interesting game so far. Alright, I think it was this tree here. Let's see if we're in the right place now. Yeah, it's covering it, so why would this be here? There's no fuel point. Is that going to give us any more clues? No. It's definitely... it's got something to do with this fuel can. Let's just move it back a bit. Right, the fuel can's there. Oh, we had a weird sound then. What was that? One last look at the body before I move the train further up. This must be something we've missed. Oh, there we go. What on earth? Oh, I can move. I didn't know I could actually move. And now it's showing us what the actual... okay, he's talking to the... get off my land, farmer. Right, and what's this then? Is this where he caves his head in? And he goes to get the rock. Ooh, what happens? Some sort of accident, isn't it? Ah, so it wasn't his blood. So why has he got no legs? The kid was tied to the... chronological order. Okay, so the kid... he finds a kid... he finds a kid tied to the tracks. He runs out of fuel. Oh, hang on, no, I'm going to make that the first one. He comes up. No. He's already got that in his hands, so. He finds a body. He finds a body. He tells the train driver that he's found a body. Right. He finds the body. Let's do this right. He finds the body. Oh, hang on, though. Oh, see, because the kid's there already, innit? Right, well, we know that he's asking him for the crankshaft. So, God, why can't I work this out? How can this be so difficult? He has an argument with the train driver. Because he wants some fuel. No. Hey up, mate. Train's coming along. Chug, chug, chug. Excuse me. You're going to... Oh, God. Why is this so difficult? Surely that's the first one. But he's got the fucking crowbar in his hands. So is it the train driver? Yes, it is. Excuse me, mate. Can I have some fuel? No, you can't. Fuck off. Right then, you little bastard. I'm going to get a rock and cave your head in. Oh, yeah? You want to try and do that to me, mate? Then I'm going to tie your little shit to the fucking train track. Oh, you are you? Oh, fuck. Have it. Oh my God. How did the little kid end up on the train track? That's got to be the last one. Oh my God, this is really not easy. So we know that the train track driver is alive here. He's driving along. But then, if he's here, then how does he end up fucking with his legs chopped off? Right, we're going to have that as one. Train's coming along here. He finds the kid tied up. He finds the blood. He finds the blood. Tells this old guy there's a guy on the rail track. Get fucked! Give me some fuel, you little bastard. Oh, then the kid's already there. What the fuck? Did you tie a kid to the rail track, Grandad? No, I didn't. Get fucked. Right, get yourself on then, you old bastard. Right then, you say that to me, I'm going to cave your fucking head in with this rock. Oh, you are you? You are you? Meanwhile, what the fuck is this up here? This fucking blood on the fucking... Yes, mate, that's right. Right then, I'm gonna get this and cave your fucking head in. And I think we may have got it.
Listen to me. We can destroy it. I know how.
You can't destroy it, Ethan. You can't destroy time. And that's what he is. He is forever.
Travis, tell me where Ethan is.
Interesting. So So, I'm not going to spoil this for you guys. Obviously, because if you're watching it. So, I shall see you in the next part after I've worked this out. But so far, I am loving this game. Something different. Very, very enjoyable. And I shall see you coming in part 3. I'm actually not going to spoil some of the visuals or the solutions to some of the puzzles. But we'll take the journey together. I've been Para, and this has been the disappearance of Ethan Hawke. No, it's not. Ethan Carter. More coming in part 2.
Bye-bye.
Hello, and welcome back to part 3 of The Vanishing of Ethan Carter. I actually did solve the puzzle up here, and on purpose I haven't put it in so that it doesn't spoil it should you want to play it. Interesting. Probably not quite what you thought it was going to be during the murder scene. And the spirits actually just left his body and went down to that rock pool, which is down there. So we're literally just going to run down now and have a look. Presume this is going to take us to the... Oh, there's one there. What's that down there?
Grandpa? Stay away!
Ethan, I'm sick too. I can feel the sleeper in my head.
Then fight it! I have to destroy the room!
Corvus, I'm sorry. Ethan.
Oh no!
I can't let you do that.
Wow.
Whatever had turned Ethan's family against him, the grandfather was trying to resist. Age helps against those things that feed on hate. Not because of wisdom or experience. Because the old are tired. Their hate is less useful.
Wow, and I think what we'll do is we'll actually have this as the end of the second video. So ignore me saying that this is part 3. So that's actually, let's call it scene 1. That's going to bring completion of this second video to an end before we move on to the next part. And obviously I've got no idea where we go from here. Let's get a cup of tea and just sit here and relax. Smell the pine trees. Feel the wind in your hair. Beautiful. Anyway, more coming in the third video, and I shall speak to you soon. Cheers. Bye-bye.